to Rooftop Records. My name is Amy. Have you been here before? No. How did you hear about us? From a friend. Okay, cool. So, what are you looking for today? Birthday presents? Nice. Okay, two twin brothers. Okay. So, what kind of music are they? Be a little overwhelming to go through our store, so I'll show you some of our most popular records, and we can go from there. Okay. So first, I'm gonna show you this one. So this record is called "Strange Desire" by the Bleachers, and it's relatively new. Came out last year, so it's pretty popular right now, especially for people who like new popular music, you know, top 40s. It's kind of a pop alternative genre, and okay, so they like that band, then they'll probably like the Bleachers. Cool. And it has two sides, like most records. And yeah, I think it's pretty good. Okay. So we can put this in the maybe pile. One of my favorites, Simon and Garfunkel, The Greatest Hits. It has all the best music by them on it. You know, the popular ones. Pretty much the entire soundtrack to The Graduate. So, if you like that movie, or if they like that movie, it's just a classic album. A little more expensive, even though it's one of our used albums. You can tell the side. It has a little wear and tear, but the record plays like new, so that's what's important. And I think old records are cool, especially when they've been used, because they kind of are. I always thought it was interesting that the title was written in pink. Maybe it was red once and it faded. So this is a good album if they're looking for something a little more classic, old school. Okay, maybe not. Yeah. Okay, they might already have it. Yeah. Okay, well, along those lines, we also have old school. Some Frank Sinatra. I think you can never go wrong with Frank. He just has that classic voice. So this is his That Old Feeling record, and it has some pretty good songs on it. Autumn in New York. It's one of my favorites. The Nearness of You, it's a good one. And let's see, what else? other popular records from the same era, which I think is pretty cool. And the artwork. So it has some jazz, some Broadway. Johnny Cash is in there. He was okay. So that's a cool insert that comes with the record. This is obviously also a previously used record. And it's a little cheaper because it does have more wear and tear on the top. We make sure that all of our records play well and you can hear them. None of them are warped, so you can guarantee that quality. Okay, so what about this one? Okay, we'll put it with the other maybe, the bleachers. Okay, so this one. This is also a very popular record right now. Well, it's been popular since it came out. This is Bon Iver, and it's titled Bon Iver. This is his first. A lot of people think of him as kind of, you know, cliche now because everybody kind of liked him at one point, but I just think he's really talented, and I mean, this artwork is beautiful. It's kind of like a watercolor. So this is one of those records display. So, if you wanted, you could give it to your friend in like a case or a frame, and they could hang it up. And there are frames out there that the glass isn't on the front, so it would be easy for them to take it out and listen to. Also has some really nice artwork. So this is a nice album to display just open, sitting on a table. I think the colors are really pretty. So that's a really classic one. And, well, not classic, but, you know, you can't really go wrong. Okay. You think they hate Bon Iver? Okay, great. So, we won't put that in the pile. Okay. You mentioned they like Broadway. One of them does. Okay. So, we have quite a few. Let's see. Let me check over here. Okay. So, we have quite a few Broadway albums. We have this musical, Godspell. This is a pretty popular one, so if they're into Broadway, I'm sure that they've seen this. Maybe you know about it, or maybe they have mentioned it to you. Okay. Too religious, maybe? Okay. Well, another classic is Fiddler on the Roof. This is a really old one, and this is actually from the movie. It's adapted. And the inside is of smells like an old book, which I've read is mold that actually is the reason that it smells like that. So when you're breathing that in, you're breathing in mold. But I like the smell. Then the last page. I think it's a really cool set. It comes with all of that, and you can just tell how old it is. It doesn't say the year. I'm sure. This one. So this is one of my favorites. David Bowie. Heroes is the record name. Or the album name. And it's still in the plastic casing. Because it's really nice record, and it's still in really good condition, so we keep a lot of our older ones in plastic. It's a nice sound. This is my favorite David Bowie album. Probably because Heroes is on it, which is one of my favorite songs by him. which is cool. So this was released in 1977. So it's pretty old. I'll take it out just so you can look at it. So, like I said, it's in really good condition. And I'm not going to take the record. Great album. Do you think they'd be interested in this? Oh, you would? Okay. So, do you want to buy this one? Okay, great. Sometimes you find things for yourself when you're looking for other people. I do that all the time. Okay, so I'll put this one back in the sleeve. So, I think I have, two more to show you, and, right, so this is a classic, and this is Pink Floyd, The Wall, doesn't say anything on it, but it's an icon. Pretty sure most people know this. It says it was released in 1979, so right after the David Bowie album. This one's listed at $30 because it is two records and a lot of songs. Well, some of them are long. Since it's old, you can see the outline of the record inside, which I think is kind of cool. And this is the inside. Some interesting artwork. If you've seen the movie The Wall, I believe some of these are in it, and if you haven't seen it and you're a Pink Floyd fan, I highly recommend it because it kind of gives you more insight into the reason for him writing this album. It's kind of gone a little crazy, but it's really fun. The records themselves. Anybody out there? Is there anybody there? I really, really, really like this album. Comfortably Numb is probably my favorite song. But I also really like Pink Floyd, and this is kind of a good starter album if you've never listened to them, or if you've only heard a couple of their songs. So do you think this would be something that your friend would be interested in? Okay. Yeah, it's a little expensive. Especially for a birthday. I'll put this in after. me see. So, this is a folkier kind of genre. This is Iron and Wine. Our Endless Number of Days is the album name. I think this artwork is fantastic. Looks like it could be hanging up in a museum. Iron and Wine is, if you don't know them, I think they're fantastic. They're kind of acquired taste. You either like them or you really don't. Kind of along the same vein as Bon Iver, but not exactly the same. So, this is a really good, simple album. If your friend is into this kind of folky music. So you have three right now. You have the David Bowie for yourself, the Iron and Wine, and the Fiddler on the Roof. So that's one for each of them. Yeah, great. Okay. You want to see? Okay, yeah. We do actually have some Hall & Oates, so we have this one, which is really funky. This is a good album. It looks so like 80s. But this is actually, this is on special for $2. Because we have quite one other Hall & Oates album, I think. A used one. Let me check. Okay, so this is a really old one. This is the Abandoned Luncheonette one. And this is actually $1.98 also, so you can get both of them for $4. Yeah. If you love Hall & Oates, then you can't really go wrong. And this actually was from 1973. And it's really cool because someone has put the braille on the back, which I'm only assuming says Hall & Oates or the album name, or maybe even the track names. Really well used, but like I said before, all of our albums play really well, and if they don't, you can always bring them back in and we'll listen to it, and if it really doesn't play well, we'll refine.